Chiefs beat the Broncos, baby. I mean, look, it was never even really close. I mean, just from the beginning of the game, you just kind of like knew that. I don't know. But yeah, look, the Chiefs get the win against the Denver Broncos. We sweep them again. And what that means is that if we beat the Chargers in week 17 in 2 weeks from now, then we have swept the division. That means we're 6-0 in the division. That's insane. We did it in 2016 somehow. Lost the Raiders in 2017. Lost to the Chargers in 2018. So I don't know, man. I don't know. But the last time the Chiefs lost to the Broncos, it was so long ago. It was I think it was October of 2015. I mean, it's just, I love it. When you have a division rival that you dislike, like I dislike the Broncos, you love not being able to remember when the last time they beat you was. It's a good feeling. Okay, so every season I do this little paper here where I'll draw out every opponent, where we play them, and when the last time the Chiefs won in that location was. Does that make sense? So for example, the last time we beat the Houston Texans at Arrowhead Stadium was October 20th of 2013. And so I did not cross that out and replace it because we lost that game. So that's just, I've been doing this. This is the third year I've been doing this. It's kind of just useless, but it's just a kind of a way to have fun, you know? We played against Drew Lock, and I'm not even gonna lie, Drew Lock was the only quarterback out of last year's draft class that I actually liked. You feel me? Like, I watched a few Mizzou games last season, and Drew Lock was balling, dude. Like, he's a baller. And so I was like, oh no, when Denver drafted him, because like, look, he's not a bad quarterback. I mean, he balled out against the Texans last week, but he's from Missouri. Went to college Mizzou. Went to high school Lee Summit, which is fairly close to Kansas City. I mean, and I'm pretty sure he grew up a Chiefs fan. This is homecoming for him. He's a quarterback for the Broncos now. And so, you know, it's kind of cool that he's coming into his whole old home, you know? And so there's that. But shit, man, let's get into the recap. Today's game, the weather was insane. I mean, it was pretty much a blizzard out there. It was just snowing the entire game. It did not stop. It looked pretty brutal. I just want to point out that even though we were playing in a blizzard, Patrick Mahomes still threw for 340 yards. I mean, who does that in a blizzard? I mean, not many quarterbacks can do that, but Patrick Mahomes did. And in the past few recaps, I've said that, I don't know, Mahomes is looking a bit off, it seems like. I don't really know what his deal is. But today, he looked like Patrick Mahomes. Shit, let's just get into the recap. Broncos start the game with the ball. It's a three and out. And so they punt it. The Chiefs get it. And on the fourth play of the drive for the Chiefs, Patrick Mahomes throws a 41-yard deep bomb dime. Straight dime, Tyreek Hill, and we get the touchdown. However, because of the snow, Dustin Cole quit when he tries to hold the ball for the extra point. He bobbles it, and then he tries to throw it to Anthony Sherman instead, and so that failed. And so really, we didn't get a touchdown. It was more like two field goals. And so instead of 7-0, it's 6-0. All right, the Broncos get the ball back, and they punt. Chiefs get the ball back, and on a 12-play drive that lasted 6 minutes and 48 seconds, it resulted in a field goal by Harrison Butker, a 23-yarder, and the Chiefs are up 9-0. And that would end the first quarter. Second quarter starts. The Broncos get the ball, and it's a 3-and-out. They punt it. The Chiefs get the ball back. Mahomes throws a deep bomb to Sammy Watkins for 29 yards. And so that set up a couple of other short plays. The Chiefs end up settling for a field goal at Harrison Butker, 24-yarder. We give the ball back to the Broncos, and their drive lasts 11 plays, and they get on the board. They score a field goal. It's a 32-yarder from McManus, and it's 9-3. Kansas City's up. And then the Chiefs get the ball back with 2 minutes left in the half, and it results in another field goal. But Butker makes a 44-yard field goal, and the Chiefs are up 15-3 to end the half. So to start the third quarter, the Chiefs get the kickoff, they get the ball. Travis Kelce was balling today. Travis Kelce picked up a few first downs on this drive, and then it resulted eventually in Patrick Mahomes throwing a 5-yard touchdown pass to Tyreek Hill. And the Chiefs go for a 2-point to make up for the missed field goal earlier in the game. And Mahomes somehow, some way avoids a sack and just throws a dart, Sammy Watkins, and we get the 2 point. And so now we're up 23-3. And so for the rest of the game, not very much happens. Broncos get the ball, they punt, the Chiefs get the ball back, it's a 3-and-out, and then the Broncos get the ball back, and Drew Lock actually throws an interception to Juan Thornhill, who picked it off, and then the Chiefs get the ball back, and in a great, great drive with a couple of deep bombs to the tight ends, Blake Bell and Travis Kelce, we would get really close to the end zone, and Patrick Mahomes throws one of his rare interceptions, and it's just there wasn't much he could do. You know, he was scrambling out of the pocket. He tried to throw a dart to Tyreek Hill, and he was double covered, and they got the ball. So there was that an interception for an interception is basically what that was, and that ends the third quarter. The fourth quarter begins. The Broncos end up having a 10-play drive. They go for it on fourth down, and they don't get it. Chiefs, it's a turnover on downs. The Chiefs get the ball back. Chiefs have another 3-and-out. So there's that. And then the Broncos get it, and then they have an 11-play drive that lasts 3 minutes, and they end up failing on fourth down once again. And then the Chiefs get the ball back, run a few plays, get the first down, kneel it, game over. And so that's all it is. And the Chiefs, that's it. The Chiefs win. And the Chiefs, once again, have swept the Broncos in the regular season. We have not lost to the Broncos since 2015, which for me feels like a really long time ago. Some of you older fans out there might seem like it happened fairly recently, but for me, you know, that feels like a long time ago. Travis Kelce balled out today. I just want to say that. He balled out today. He had, I'm pretty sure he ended the game with more offensive yards than the entire Denver Broncos team had. And with this baller performance, he actually sets an NFL record. Travis Kelce is now the first tight end in NFL history to have four straight 1,000 yard seasons. That's insane. Congratulations, Travis Kelce. I mean, he's unarguably the best tight end in the NFL right now. You can't argue it. It's the fact. And with the way he's been playing these past few years, I mean, he's setting himself up to be one of the greatest tight ends to ever play in the NFL. He's very good, is what I'm saying. He's very good. But yeah, I mean, the Chiefs, we play the Chicago Bears Sunday Night Football next week. Gross. The NFL really needs to fix that, because that's a meaningless game, dude. The Bears are not going to make the playoffs, and then the Chiefs have already won the division. Like, that's not a good Sunday night game at all. There's better games to put on Sunday night next week. The NFL won't flex any games, so Chiefs have to settle for the Sunday night football. I don't like Sunday night football games. I like to watch the 1 o'clock games where I can see other games going on as well. I don't like to wait all day, because I'm filming this recap right now at 8 o'clock. The Sunday night game hasn't even started yet. Tonight's Bills Steelers. I mean, it hasn't even started yet. It won't start for 30 minutes. I hate waiting all day for a game to start, and that's going to be like the fourth time this season that the Chiefs have had a night game. We had a Thursday night, Monday night. This will be our second Sunday night, or will it be our third? I don't know, but we've had too many night games. I don't like it, but that's one of the cons of being one of the better teams in the NFL. Anyways, with that being said, I'm going to get out of here. Go Chiefs, baby. Peace out.